Welcome back, and thank you for listening to the new to the paradigm shift, the work that God has done, the things that He has empowered you and I to do, the faithful ones, the chosen children of the Most High God that have been chosen to walk with Him in this hour, in these days, to serve others, to love one another, others, to serve one another for all of eternity. This is the defining hour of your faith, of your belief, of your hope, and of your love, to show that truly God is with us. God loves beyond measure. And it's not that He can't do this Himself, but God loves to share His treasure. He wants His children to be an active part of his existence. For we are a part of the existence. For we exist using the breath, breathing the very breath of Yod-Heh-Yahveh, Yahweh, our Father in Heaven, who fills our lungs. Ah, it's such a joy. It's hard to even go forward because the joy abounds within, you know, to leap out, to come out. Okay, so back to Mexico, to the earthquake and the children entrapped in the elementary school. And let it be known that there's work being done. There are many angels on the scene. So here's how does this unfold. So there we are. After coming to them the first time and giving the children the bread and the water and singing with them, singing to them, literally, to lull them into a peaceful sleep, that the bread and the water do its full work. And then later, He had me come back to them again and revisit and let them know God has never left you. God is here with you, and I know that you know that. And He has asked me to come back to you again because He wants us to sing together. Now that you know about Him, our loving, living God of heaven and earth, He wants you to rejoice, to be happy, and to just trust Him and to be at peace. And so we began to sing just silly songs, just silly happy songs, things that children might sing that we could sing along together. And then He had me stand up on my feet and on my earth feet and to say, okay, everybody, stand up now. All right, everybody, stand up. Stand up and raise your arms up into the air. We're going to lift this building. We're going to shake it. We're going to shake this building so they know where you are. All right, we're going to lift this building up. Are you ready? All right, everybody, on the command, just like as the people and the priest in the times before, in the days of Joshua, took their shofars and walked round about the fort, and were going to bring it down in Jericho. They walked round about and they brought it down. Well, He had it. It was in that same kind of thing, in a full faith, no knowledge that this will happen, no zero doubt. So, to tell the children, all right, everybody, stand up. Stand up, and their existence, they remember they were standing up, they would stand up spiritually and raise the building up. He said, you are going to be superheroes. I am making you superheroes today. He was talking to them on a child's level. It was so glorious to be a part of, but the child in me delighted in it just the same. Today, you are going to be superheroes. I am giving you superpower, and we're going to lift this building, and I want you to shout with a mighty voice. I want you to shout with one voice. Your mouth may not be able to move, but we will hear you. You shout as loud as you can. Shout and call upon the Lord. Call upon the Lord. Call upon the Lord. Shout. Call. And they will hear. And after that became reports that sounds were heard within the building. Came reports that sounds had been heard. Praise God, from whom every loving kindness and mercy flows. Praise God. praise God. Praise God that I was allowed to be there and witness. And so we sang, and then there came this song as we're standing with our arms up, holding, lifting the building, and our backs strengthened. And he's, and the song came, "If you're happy and you know it." So I began to sing, "If you're happy and you know it." And then I thought of the words that would come next, "Clap your hands." And I went, "Oh, no, don't turn loose. Don't do that." And God gave me peace. And he said, like Keeley said, it will not come back down. They have lifted it spiritually. And every inch they lift, every inch they lift, it will not come, it will not recede, it will not come back down upon them. Lift with all your heart. So I said, okay, I just laughed, and I'm like, so to do, you know, to be doing, if you're happy and you know it, clap your hands like that, and to rejoice with the children, teach them to sing, dance, and praise, and then teach everything else. So how does this measure up with the paradigm shift? We have been given a new power. You must be actively willing to let the child in you come out and rejoice in the season. There are no walls that separate you any longer from that which your heart goes to help in, if it be in the will of God. Do you think it's in God's will to save hurting people? To feed hungry people, to heal the sick and the broken? Do you think it's in God's will that you go and minister to those in need, to share His love? I'll let you answer that for yourself. And I hope you say a big hallelujah, amen, amen, and aho. I love you guys. From here in Jerusalem, Israel, CJ, over and out.